What we have here is a failure to communicate. Because what's been communicated to me thus far about the big boss man is what a fair and honest man he was, what a just prison guard he was at the Cobb County Correctional Institute. Well, I'm here in Cobb County today to tell you people that that was all a bunch of bunk. Because I have a man right here that tells a totally different story. Hey, did you ever spend any time in jail?
Yes, Cobb County Correctional Institute.
The Cobb County Correctional Institute. And while you were at the Cobb County Correctional Institute, did you know a man they call the Big Boss Man?
Yes.
It's okay. Don't be scared. Don't be scared. You knew the Big Boss Man. Well, tell me, was he a fair and honest man? Was
No.
he a just man?
No.
No, it's okay. Don't be scared. I'll take care of you. Listen, he wasn't fair. He wasn't honest. Well, then tell me, how did he treat you?
He used to come in at night and handcuff me and beat me.
And beat you. How long did he beat you?
All night.
Beat you all night long.
All
so what
night.
You're telling me is that he treated you like a dog.
No, nobody treats a dog like that.
Nobody treats a dog like that. That's what I've been saying all along. This is an example of a big boss man's justice. A man reduced to shoveling dirt. And that boss man is just what you are, a great big pile of dirt. Well, here I am. I've come down here to the deep south, to the very roots of the big boss man, to this despicable place he calls home, Cobb County, Georgia, to expose him for what he really is. And who do I have standing next to me? None other than one of his old high school teachers, Miss Cofer. Now, Miss Cofer, let me ask you a few questions about the boss man. Tell me, what kind of a student was he? Was he an intelligent boy?
No. I've been teaching for 20 years, and he's probably the worst student I've ever had.
Worst student you've ever had. Well, what kind of grades did he make?
Fs. All Fs.
No Bs, no Cs.
No. In fact, he was so bad, we kept him in the dunce corner most of the time. We've renamed it now. Big Boss Man Corner.
Big Boss Man Corner. Well, was he at least an honest child?
No, he had to cheat to make the Fs he made.
And lie?
Oh, yeah.
So what you're telling me, Miss Cofer, is that he cheated and he lied and he still couldn't make the grade.
You got that.
So you see, boss man, from the mouth of one of your own teachers right here in Cobb County, Georgia, I've proven what I've said all along. You're nothing but a big, dumb, illiterate hick from Cobb County, Georgia. And just like the rest of the hicks from Cobb County, you, boss man, have a price for the $1 million man. But you're too stupid to realize it. I've already proved to the entire world what a complete and total idiot you were in school, a complete and total dunce. And well, boss man, here I am on the very football field where you supposedly played ball, and look who's here standing with me, your old high school football coach, Coach Patton. Now tell me, Coach Patton, did the big boss man play football here?
Well, Mr. DiBiase, if you want to call it that, he was on the team.
He was on the team. Well, let me ask you this then. You know, football's a game of a great deal of coordination. You got to be real fleet of foot. How coordinated was the big boss man?
Coordinated? He couldn't walk and chew chewing gum at the same time. I used to think he had lace on his panties.
Lace on his panties. I like that. Well, tell me this then, Coach. You know, football's a hitting game. You got to be tough. You got to get in there. You got to hit.
You got it.
Right. What kind of hitter was the boss man?
The boss man. He couldn't crack an egg, Mr. DiBiase.
Couldn't crack an egg. Well, if he couldn't crack an egg and he wasn't a hitter, what position did he play? What was he, a guard?
Yeah, he was a guard. He guarded the water bucket and watched the cheerleaders.
You see, boss man, I've proved it one more time. You're a complete and total hick from a hick school in a hick town in a hick county. And you, boss man, just like all the other hicks in this county, have got a price for the $1 million man. You know, they say one picture's worth 1,000 words. So rather than go on and on about the big boss man's background, I thought I'd bring you here to the very neighborhood where he grew up. So take a long, hard look around you and judge for yourself, because this is Cobb County class. Hey, kid, come here. I want to talk to you for a minute. Even smells funny in the air, probably a pig farm somewhere nearby. Hey, boy, is this the big boss man's neighborhood? Did he grow up here?
Yeah, but we don't like to claim him around here.
You don't like to claim him? Well, why not? What kind of a guy was he?
I used to like to beat up on me and my friends.
Used to beat up on you and your friends? Well, you don't look like you could be as old as a big boss man. You must have been a little boy.
Yeah, we all were.
You were all little boys. A big boss man beat up on little kids?
All the time.
Well, what about somebody like me? What about somebody that was his own size looking right in the eye?
Wouldn't be around you.
Wouldn't be around you. In other words, if you were as big as he was, he'd turn tail and run.
Yeah.
Oh, so what you're really saying is the boss man was the neighborhood bully.
Yeah.
You see, there's just one more shining example of what I've said all along about you, boss man. You aren't what you appear to be. You can't change the spots on a leopard. You can't change the stripes on a tiger. You always were, and you always will be, a great big, obnoxious bully. But you know what, boss man? You and every other hick in Cobb County, Georgia, still have a price for the $1 million man.